Hey, this is WhyBeAre with BeamNG Drive, and today we're going to be doing the BOLLARD crush test. Now, first off, what is a BOLLARD? Because I do not use this in my videos very often. In real life, a BOLLARD is just a really thick pole that's mounted into the ground. Now, on BeamNG Drive, this pole can move up and down, and it's basically indestructible. So to show you just how strong this is, we're gonna get a big fat T-75 Patriots special version of the T-Series, and whenever you spawn this up, you gotta salute. And we're gonna take this thing all the way back to the end of the road over here, and we're gonna smash into the BOLLARD going probably about 50 miles per hour. There are very few things that can stop a T-Series going 50 miles per hour. This BOLLARD, however, is one of those few things. And boy, does it stop it fast. So we're going about 55 miles per hour, and it doesn't even flinch. It just annihilates the T-Series on impact. It didn't stand a chance. The BOLLARD is that strong. So I said crush test. That's just a crash test. So let's get the T-Series off of this. And then we need to go to the map editor. And we are going to flip the BOLLARD upside down so that we can use it to crush a vehicle. The first thing we need to do is hit Shift C to move the camera around freely. Then we need to find the logo for the BOLLARD. Click that, make sure we're in rotation mode, and then rotate it upside down. If it's a little crooked, that's okay. You can go over here and just make sure it says 180. So it's rotated 180 degrees from where it is normally. And then we need to raise it up into the air so there's enough room to put a car under it. So I'm gonna keep on raising it a little bit more until it looks like we have enough clearance. That should be good for most vehicles. A T-Series is not gonna fit under there, but a regular car should. So now hit F11 to go back into the game. Go back to the T-Series and replace it with a regular vehicle. So how about we use an Abishu Miramar and we'll get the street tuned version so we can have a nice sporty car to crush. And then all we're gonna do is we're gonna drive directly under the BOLLARD nice and slowly so it's centered right in the center of the vehicle. So that looks pretty good to me, right in the center of the vehicle. And now we go to the BOLLARD and then we hit page up and page down to control it. Now here's where things get confusing, because up is down and down is up. Because if you hit up, it goes down. And if you hit down, it goes up according to the controls up there. So all I'm gonna say from now on is there's a crush mode and a not crushing mode, because it makes it less confusing. This is crush mode, and boy does it crush. It just goes right through the car like butter. The whole roof smooshed. It's basically a convertible at this point. That's what it looks like. It looks like a convertible. It got squished that well. And the best part is, it should still drive great. That shouldn't do any damage to the drivetrain, you would think. Maybe it did some damage after all, or it might just be stuck a little bit. So we're gonna go ahead and save it, reset it, and then load. And does it drive now? Oh yes, it does. How well does it drive? We're just gonna see coasting in a straight line, basically. Straight, that thing drives straight. Steering works great. In fact, this car probably handles better now because there's more weight lowered to the ground. You have a lower center of gravity, that gives you better handling, right? Makes sense to me. As for aerodynamics though, I have no idea. It's just a mess of metal, which could be worse, could be better. There's really no way to know. But yeah, it drives great. So now we're gonna bring the car back over there. We'll reload it, and then we'll get it ready for round two of crushing. And for round two, we're gonna go ahead and try to crush the trunk of the vehicle. And we're just gonna try to do the exact same thing as last time, basically. Put it right in the middle of the vehicle, right on the trunk. So that should be good. Yep, that looks pretty centered to me. Once again, we are the BOLLARD, and we are in crush mode. We are gonna flatten this trunk all the way to the ground, just like we did for the roof. And that is a lot of pressure on that rear suspension. I don't know if it's gonna be able to drive after that. Have my fingers crossed though. Completely ruined the rear end. Doesn't even look like it had a trunk ever now. But does it drive? Yes. How well does it drive? That's still a straight line. Guys, this thing still drives great. And once again, I have theoretically improved the handling of the vehicle because it has a lower center of gravity. And since we already got this thing driving and I saved up the damage we have, we'll do a little just crash right here and see how much it bends with all this damage already. Oh, actually, it held up surprisingly well. That was an 80 mile per hour crash with an older vehicle. I expected the frame to really bend, but it still held its shape. We aren't done yet, though. We've crushed the roof. We've crushed the trunk. There's one part left we haven't crushed. That is the hood with the engine in it. Now, this might break the vehicle because engines usually don't like being crushed that much. And since the engine sits so low to the ground, I'm going to go ahead and just lower this a little bit more to make sure it's nice and centered. It's easier to see when it's nice and close to the hood. So that looks like it's centered left and right. Just got to make it centered forward and back. All right. That looks pretty good. Perfect. And now, once again, it is time to crush. 3, 2, 1, go! Crushing the engine. Will it live? Let's find out. It is going straight through the engine block. The front suspension is having none of this. It really went down. It's smoking now. It has like a coolant leak at least. Does it even run? It has an idle sound still. It could run. Okay, it's once again stuck. We can fix that. We save, reset, load. And let's see. Does it drive? Yes, it does. Somehow, after all of that, it still drives. And not only that, it's almost going in a straight line. It has like a little bit of a pull to the right, you can see. But that is very, very minor. Looking at this vehicle, this is the most damaged I've ever seen a car that still drives well. Heck, if I wanted to, I could go and drive this thing on the freeway and it's fine there. Most of the time, when a car looks like this, it's gonna crawl along inch by inch. It's not gonna drive along on the highway at highway speeds. That's not gonna happen 99% of the time. But when you have a controlled crush using the Bollard, you can get something that's completely ruined looking and drives great. So here we go. This really should bend the vehicle when it crashes here. Watch the frame. There's the bend. That's what I expected to really see the first time because the frame structure is so messed up. It just is not strong like it was originally. And you hit the wall like that, it will bend. And you know what? Just for comparisons, we can go ahead and pull out another one of these guys and do the exact same impact and you can see the difference. I don't know what he's doing inside the wall, all crooked and stuff. We just gotta bring him all the way back here to make sure we're about the same speed. We were going like 80 miles per hour, so we gotta go about 80 miles per hour with this guy as well. What are you doing on your side, man? Come on. There you go, now you're ready for driving. And you can already tell it drives worse, because the center of gravity is so high, when you slam on the brakes, it doesn't stop in time and it smashes into the wall. No, actually, that's just me driving badly. It doesn't really matter though. I mean, we're gonna wreck this car in 20 more seconds anyways, so what's a little bit of damage on the bumper when we're not even comparing that side of the vehicle? We're looking at the front side. We gotta hold this thing tight to make sure you don't accidentally crash into the car we already crashed. Perfect. And that thing, yes, it really crumpled at the front. Because it's an old car, it's gonna crumple no matter what. But the frame did not bend. It's still nice and straight here. And you look at this guy, it's just, my goodness, has it bent. And that's because it's been weakened so much by the crushing from the Bollard. That's cool. All right, now let's play around with a different vehicle. How about we go with an ETK 800 and we're gonna get the 856 TT Sport Plus in a nice solar yellow color. And what we're gonna do is we're just gonna completely crush this thing little by little. We're gonna start with the back of the vehicle and slowly work our way over to the front where the whole thing gets crushed. We're probably gonna use like 5 or 6 crushes in total, I would guess, to completely crush it. But at that point, it should look like a completely different vehicle. In fact, you know what? After just one crush, it looks like a completely different vehicle. You would not know that this was once a wagon. In fact, you know what I did? I made a ute. I made a nice 4-door ute. That's amazing. And it drives still, just as you'd expect. The Miramar was not a fluke, so it's lined up to be right in the middle of the vehicle, and there goes the roof. This thing can remove the roof of any vehicle. Anything can be a convertible when you use the Bollard. It is truly. Now we need to move up a little bit more and crush the dash of the vehicle. And I see a little bit of metal that we kind of missed in the back. So we might have needed an extra crush right there. We'll come back to that one in a second. Right now though, dash destruction. I'll kind of push the car forward just a little bit so the dash doesn't really want to be crushed, but it doesn't matter. It still crushed the dash a decent amount. And this thing, it's a bathtub. It's literally shaped like a bathtub now. Go ahead and get that piece of metal that's just sticking up right there from the roof. We want the roof down as low as it can go. All the way down. Yes. Okay. Hopefully the rear suspension can take that, because that was really right on the rear suspension. And now it's even more of a bathtub than before. Now here's where things might get a little bit bad. We're going to try crushing the engine as well, and crushing the engine might just break the vehicle. I'm not really sure how well crushing the engine will work. We might have had a fluke, to be honest, on the Miramar for that. For the regular drivability, though, I do not think that was a fluke. But oh, looking at the engine, oh no. That engine is all warped up. I see a little bit of smoke coming out of it. Oh, this is not looking promising now. Let's see, can it do anything? Okay, it could still maneuver. We're going to keep crushing. We got to crush the front of the vehicle, too. At this point, we will have crushed every single zone of the vehicle except basically the bumpers. And it's okay if the bumpers stay there, because I kind of like having the bumpers just intact a little bit so you can see this is what the vehicle used to look like in between the bathtub I've made. Like, if you crushed the bumpers, it wouldn't look like a bathtub. It would just be a pancake. I like the bathtub. Oh, no, it doesn't drive. Wait, actually, it might just be stuck, remember? The other one got stuck, so we do a little save load, and it drives. Somehow, this drives. What is this? This was a car. It's not a car anymore. It's a platform with wheels. And not only does it drive, it's driving again. Almost straight. Once again, just a little bit of pull to the right, but completely drivable without any serious issue. You know how I mentioned the last vehicle was the most damage I've ever seen the drive still? We got a new record holder. This one looks even worse. Drives just as good as the other one did. Unbelievable how powerful that Bullard is. Although, you know how I said it makes the handling better because the center of gravity is lower? Not really sure if that's the case, because you see how wobbly this thing is? Like, that's something we'll have to test eventually in a separate video, but the frame is so wobbly, I think it's lost its structure, and that makes it handle worse. Anyways, here's a little crash that should bend it up. Oh! Well, even with all the crushing, it didn't really bend the frame, although it didn't really get a nice direct impact like the Miramar. That was kind of like a little bump impact that flew it into the air, and it was able to kind of conserve some energy. And just looking at that thing, my goodness. How was that driving before that impact? I will never understand it. Like, the engine is mush. And it was still working fine. Okay, let's go ahead and crush one more vehicle, and this vehicle is going to be very different. This is going to be a T-Series. Remember the T-Series from before? He's coming back, and he's just going to get beat up even more. This poor, innocent T-Series is going to get destroyed. And you'll notice, though, T-Series is a little bit too tall. But one thing that's kind of nice is once you flip the Bollard over, it's really easy to align it with a different vehicle to crush. First, you make sure it's fully up and ready to crush. Then you just go wherever you want to crush and you hit F7 to teleport it, and it teleports it basically exactly what you expected. So it's right above the hood of the T-Series, and it's ready to crush the hood of the T-Series. Down it goes, straight into the engine bay. Gotta look from above to see what's really happening here. Oh, look at that! T-Series is actually holding up a bit. We cannot crush it all the way. You see that little bit right there? Usually it'll extend all the way, but it's actually being stopped a little bit by the T-Series. Now, I did say the Bollard is basically indestructible. I didn't say it was unstoppable. It's stoppable. It just got stopped. But it's still indestructible, basically. So we'll go ahead and put it above the T-Series and crush in the cabin as well. And again, nice and easy to place it at a different height if necessary. And it was necessary in that situation. And here you'll see it should crush all the way down because it's just crushing the cabin, which is very easy to do. In fact, it kind of slid in between the two parts of the cabin, which wasn't exactly what I was expecting to happen, but that's fine. We can just crush it a couple extra times to make sure it really gets mangled down the way I want it to. So we'll get the back of the cab next. Make sure it's all the way up. Teleport it right above the back of the cab. And then crush. This is perfectly centered. This will be crushed. It's not going to get lucky like last time we were able to slide out of it. Now, you're getting smooshed. Beautiful. Uncrush. And then we'll finish off by crushing the main cab one more time. And this one will just be a little bit lazy. We'll just go ahead and drive it backwards a bit so it'll get in there. Uh-oh, it's stuck. We can't do that. We'll just teleport it then. That works too. And crush. And it's still beeping at me trying to back up. You're not going to back up. I'm sorry. It's impossible. What is possible, though, is that you'll get crushed even harder. All right, that thing is just mangled up. We got to get driving with it, though, see if it can still drive. So save, reload, load, and how do you drive? Still going in reverse. Stop going in reverse. There we go. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, so unfortunately, the T-Series is dead. I think what happened was, remember when I was crushing the engine at the very start and I said, wow, it's not crushing all the way? When it was really crushing as hard as it could just on the engine, that did some serious damage to the engine. Thankfully, though, we have this really nice downhill section where we can just kind of coast it. Like, we got no working engine yet. We're going 35 miles per hour somehow. Doing a little e-brake maneuver to get around the corner? Yeah, sure, why not? Anyways, though, that's going to do it for this video. If you guys would be interested in seeing more videos like this one where you just crush vehicles with the BOLLARD, do leave a comment so I know, because I know, in addition to crushing them up and down like I did in this video, we could crush them side to side and do multiple BOLLARDs crushing all at once and all kinds of things like that. So leave a comment so I know. And until next time, it's WhyBeAre. And remember, if you like or dislike this video, I'll know. I can tell by how crushed the car's become. So do the right thing, and I'll see you next time.